Well, hi again, you guys. Welcome to another edition of Curtis Collects Vinyl Records. Here we are, winding down these precious days of this gorgeous summer we've had in northern Illinois. They've been glorious, and today happens to be a rainy mid to late August day, and so I thought, since I'm not going to do anything really outside this morning, I should come right down here into the record room and make a few episodes of these things that we like to call Curtis Collects Vinyl Records. If you're new here, I'm just an avid, passionate vinyl record collector. Certainly not an expert, but I love this format so much. I'll get a little sleep out of my eye. I've got my coffee over there. Sometimes it might be something else, and you can tell by the sound of my flip-flops, it is summer. So, rainy day, what song do we want to hear? Well, I mean, probably my all-time favorite Eric Clapton song is Let It Rain. My favorite version, we'll talk about that in a second, but my favorite version of it is on this epic double live album, DLA, marketed under the auspices of Derek and the Dominoes in concert. Apparently he wanted to go on a tour and really not be the headliner. He was kind of tired with that, so he hooked up with these fabulous American musicians, Carl Radel, Bobby Whitlock, and Jim Gordon. And he met them from this other band, Delaney and Bonnie, and that sort of is a mashup that you can read about. And Let It Rain comes in on this wonderful, let's stop and look at that for a minute, himself. There he is. That is, take that in. That is beautiful. This comes in on this version, this wonderful double live album, at a whopping 17 minutes. It's the first song on side two. It's actually co-written along with Eric with Bonnie Bramlett of the Delaney and Bonnie fame. So we're going to play the version from this sort of eponymous, maybe it was kind of a pre-comeback to his real comeback, or maybe not a comeback, but he assembled a bunch of players. The players here are in this band along with various other famed musicians. One of my favorites, Bobby Keys, later with the Stones, Jim Horn, and a whole smattering. So this is the 5-minute version of Let It Rain, and we'll get it going. Thank you. kind of an, it's a fabulously upbeat song about kind of a dreary topic, rain. But I just love it so much. I think we should mention that soaring piano sort of in the last third of the song. I think it's Leon Russell, but even though the keyboard player on this album is the great Bobby Whitlock, but Bobby Whitlock is credited with vocals and organ on this studio version. So I will let you guys use those comments down below, the thumbs up, thumbs down, anything. Comments, subscribe. If you're new here, that would be a huge honor for you guys to hit the subscribe button. My loyal subscribers, thanks for being patient. You know I take a few months off and then I make these sort of in bursts. So I'm going to crank out three more. Stay tuned. I'm going to do a twofer on two very special bands that are very synonymous with the state that I grew up in, Illinois. So that's what this is. This was another edition of Curtis Collects Vinyl Records. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And we'll see you guys back here again soon.